Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, friends. Welcome back to my channel. This is Xbox power supply, Xbox 360. Its model number is CPA09-010A. It is 100 to 127 volts operated. How we can convert it to operate with 220 volts? First we will analyze the circuit and then we will modify it step by step. If you have similar power supply to this one or any power supply which have the same assignment, you can modify it line and neutral. If you will see this line, black line, it is coming here and it is connected to this jumper. This jumper is reaching here. Here we have fuse that is in brown color fuse. That is here fuse. After fuse we have this line and we have one component here, that is MOV, overvoltage arrestor. This one that is connected between this line and the output of the fuse. In the output of fuse we have this capacitor, that is class X capacitor, connected between both lines, this one and this one. So this capacitor, class X capacitor, it is 275 volts. No need to replace because it is in safe range, class X capacitor. After that this line is reaching here. Here we have jumper beside this capacitor, that is coming here. This line is coming here. Here we have inductor from this point to this point. And after this filter there is another MOV that is called Z1, that is here between these two points. After that we have another filter from this point to this, this point to this, that is here. So this is point A, point B. Now if we see this line, end of this inductor side, it is coming here at this point. And from that point we have one jumper from this side to this point. So point B is reaching to the center terminal of these capacitors, this one. After dual line filter there is NTC Z6 from this point to this terminal, that is here, this NTC. Then it is reaching to bridge rectifier. When it is reaching to bridge rectifier, then we have a jumper here between AC lines. So both terminal of AC input terminal are connected together, jumper together, and this line is reaching here. In the output we have positive voltage, one capacitor, second capacitor, and it is connected to negative terminal, and this is reaching here, this AC is reaching here. So it is working as a full wave rectifier. So we will receive voltage here at both capacitors. We can see that both capacitors are now in series. From this center point, center value, this capacitor is positive side and this is negative side. So it is working as a series connected batteries. If we check these capacitors, these are 330 micro 200 volt 330 micro 200 volt. Now first I will remove these capacitors. Now I removed both capacitors, 330 microfarad, 200 volt. Now I will remove this jumper from this point, and I will remove this jumper, and I will bring this line to the input of the bridge rectifier. This we will remove. The jumper connected between the center two points to the inductor we will remove. And we will also remove this jumper, this one and this one. This small jumper is making connection between both AC terminals. We will remove this jumper and we will remove this jumper. We will connect this line to the AC input terminal of the bridge rectifier. Let's remove it. And I will remove this jumper. I removed this small jumper that is connected between both AC input terminals. Now we disconnected this line. I removed the small jumper and I removed the large jumper that was here. But now we will connect this line to AC input terminal. We will connect this line here. I connected this jumper to AC input terminal. Before this terminal was connected here, but now I connected here. Now I will install 180 microfarad capacitor, 400 volt. Now I install this capacitor between positive terminal and this terminal I connected to this point, and I will make jumper to bring the return line here. I installed capacitor positive terminal here, negative terminal here, and I connected negative line to this point, the center point. Now we have 180 microfarad capacitor in this place. And this point I left blank. We will connect another capacitor here. Now we need to verify the bridge rectifier. If it have blocking voltage within safe limit, then we will use it. Otherwise we need to replace it. It is GBU 608 datasheet. GBU 608, this is available here, bridge rectifier. Six 08 800 volt, that's good. Blocking voltage, reverse voltage 800 volt, that's good. GBU 6 6 ampere, that's excellent. We can use it, the same bridge rectifier, we will use it. Now I will install back here because it is in safe limit. Because it have 6 ampere, 800 volt, reverse voltage, blocking voltage, so it is safe. If it is in some less voltage, that time we need to replace it. But now, no need to replace it, it is good. Now we need to verify this MOV here. N241K, so 14, that is disc diameter 14 millimeter, and 241, that means 240 volt, K 10%, 240 plus minus 10%. So we need to verify these parameters, these items. If it is in low voltage, then we need to use the higher voltage value. And our this MOV, it is also 511K, 510 volts, that's good. I will install heat shrink sleeve so that it, if any time it will blast, it will not damage the other things. I will install the pieces of heat shrink sleeve on these both components. I will connect power now. Yes, that's good. We have orange light here, and if I will check voltage at DC rail, DC voltage, I have 332 volts, that's good. And if I will turn on power, if I will make jumper between two inner pins, this pin and this pin, the green light is turned on. And now if I will check power here, between ground and the inner ring, not inner pin, inner ring, it is 12 volt. Inner pin 5 volt, inner ring 12 volts. So our power supply is now modified to operate with 220 volts. It's now AC voltage. It's working 233 volts. Now I will connect another capacitor in parallel to this capacitor. Now I am using this capacitor. This is 120 microfarad, 450 volt. If you have the same 180 microfarad, that will much better. Or if you have a single capacitor, but it is not going oversize, that time you can use. How I will install? I will bring this negative side, negative marking to this negative marking, and I will make jumper between the both negative terminals here. And positive terminal I will connect to this positive rail. I will connect positive terminal of this capacitor to this positive line, and I will make jumper to this negative side. So both capacitors will become in parallel. I soldered both negative terminals of the both capacitors, and I will solder the positive terminal with the rail, positive rail. So now this capacitor will not become a cause of fluctuation. It will provide enough capacitance to the circuit. Now I connected both capacitors, negative side, negative of this capacitor and negative of this capacitor is here, positive of this capacitor and positive this capacitor is connected to this positive rail, that is here. Now we installed this MOV, it was 240 volt, and now I installed 1468. So for safety I installed this MOV, and I installed two capacitors here. Other components are in safe limit. So now power supply is good. For final testing, we will apply power. Yes, that's good. Capacitor was charged. Power supply is on. If you enjoyed this video, hit the like button. If you have any question, please write in the comments.